Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Fulgham Law Firm. Welcome to our YouTube channel. Here today, I want to talk to you a little bit about the subject, how to beat a shoplifting case. Five ways to get a shoplifting case dismissed in Texas. And if you wait around to the end of this video, I'll also provide you a free ebook, What to Do If You Have Been Charged with a Crime in Texas. So thanks for joining us today. And by the way, if you like what you hear today, I encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel for more great content just like this. Okay, so shoplifting charges in Texas. What are the laws as it relates to shoplifting? Well, let's talk about what the Texas Penal Code says. Texas Penal Code Section 31.03 addresses theft, which includes shoplifting. Okay, that's a form of theft when we talk about shoplifting. And so shoplifting is a type of theft crime, and it's defined as unlawfully taking someone else's property. And in this situation, if you're going to take someone else's property without their consent, you're talking about in a retail store environment, in some type of market environment, right? So the taking of property is unlawful when the one who takes it has an intention to permanently deprive, in this situation, the store owner of their belongings. So many shoplifting cases hinge on the element of intent. So the state of Texas must prove the element of intent to deprive the owner beyond a reasonable doubt. They must prove that element. So sometimes there's examples where there was no intent to commit the crime and it was more of a mistake or accident. We'll get into that here in just a few minutes. But how do you know whether or not a shoplifting charge is a misdemeanor or a felony? Well, it's graded the same way as theft is, okay? Theft is a misdemeanor if the value is under $2,500. Theft is a felony if it is over $2,500. It's really that simple. And I encourage you, we have some other videos on our YouTube channel that speak about the crime of theft in more specificity. But today we're talking about shoplifting specifically. So this happens so often, especially to young people, many kids, 18, 19-year-olds, even juveniles, that maybe they steal an Xbox game or a PlayStation game or something like that. They find themselves being arrested, taken to jail. Parents are just beside themselves, afraid that their child's going to have this on their permanent criminal record. Well, first of all, let's identify some defenses to shoplifting charges. Number one, it could be mistake or accident. Let's say you're walking out of a store after paying and the alarm went off as you crossed the threshold. Okay. Perhaps the clerks put an item in your bag without scanning it first. Maybe there was a mistake on the part of the actual employee. You didn't realize you hadn't even paid for it. The other example are these self-checkout lines, where I've represented elderly folks where they've gone through that line and they checked everything else out, but they forgot the bag of dog food in the very bottom that was put down there by one of the employees. And so they forgot. They paid for everything else. They had plenty of money to do it. And we show they didn't have the intent. This is not something that they were intending to do. So here, one of the first areas we attack is there may be no intent to permanently deprive the owner of that property. Second defense is you paid for the item in question, right? That's a pretty good defense. The scanning equipment may not have been working properly. And in that situation, you may not have been responsible for what happened. We've actually caught that happen a couple of times when that takes place in certain stores, Walmart and Target. Thirdly, the item in question already belongs to you. We had a client one time who was coming back to do an exchange. Now, they brought this item in with them. They learned a lesson. They should have gone to customer service first. They didn't. They went back and they went to buy some other items, and then they were going to go through the line and then they were going to go return it. The problem is loss prevention officers did not know that. They arrested them, seized all the items. Later on, we were able to show the actual receipt of the item they claimed was stolen. The item already belonged to them. Okay, that's another example. Number four, another example is someone else committed the theft. How many times we've represented another young person who was with a few of their friends. They didn't take anything, but their friends did, and they walked out the door together, and they didn't even know that their friend was taking the items. Well, in that situation, the actual district attorney's office must show more than someone being merely present. If someone, people call this aiding and abetting, really it's called, you're really talking about if someone was a party to the crime is what we're really talking about here. And so in order to prove that, there must be more than just mere presence. There must have been some actual assistance on the part of that person. So if someone else committed the crime, it may not be enough to show that you had anything else to do with it, okay? Finally, and this is a rare one, but abandoning the item. We've had some people who were thought, we thought about it. We represented a young person who said he was thinking about taking the item. He went and took a couple of Xbox games, made his way up to the front, got to the garden center, and was and just dropped it off in one of the little pots that was there. But as he was doing it, apprehended, arrested by loss prevention. Our argument was he didn't make it outside all points of sale. He abandoned the item, and he never actually intended to permanently deprive the owner of the property. That is a valid defense. So why do I say that? Well, I say that to say this. These are defenses that need to be examined in every theft case because people say, well, who cares if it's just a shoplifting charge? Even a minor shoplifting conviction could forever affect your ability to get a high-paying job. It could affect your ability to move up in the job you're in right now. Employers look at theft in many ways as bad as they do felony cases because in their mind, they will not be able to trust someone who's ever been accused and found guilty of theft. So I encourage you, you need to make sure you hire an attorney that's experienced in being able to help you make sure that you can fight your case and get that off your record. Now, if you or a loved one are facing a theft, a shoplifting charge in Texas, maybe in the North Texas area, don't hesitate to contact us at the Full Gym Law Firm at 817-877-3030. We'll be happy to answer your questions, give you a free consultation. And I promised you if you waited around to the end of this video, I'd also give you a free ebook, What to Do If You've Been Charged with a Crime in Texas. Click the link below. We'll send it over to you. Thanks again for joining us today on our YouTube channel. We'll see you next time.